I guess most people know Loch Fyne because of the oysters. I mean, is that the main part of your business?
No, it's not actually. In a way, the oysters are a bit like the icing on top of the cake from a business point of view, because the mainstay of the business is in the smoked salmon and the other smoked products that we produce in the smokehouse, just because more people eat smoked salmon than eat oysters.
Yeah.
The oysters are more of a part of our business now than they were because of the Loch Fyne restaurants. Because the Loch Fyne restaurants, actually, people go there to have oysters, I think, you know, because of the association with the name. And therefore, the oyster consumption has increased, which is great, because that's kind of what they set out to do when they started the company 30 years ago, was really to increase the number of people eating oysters, and that certainly happened over the years.
I mean, there's a number of interesting aspects to the business. I mean, one of which is that it's run as a cooperative.
Yes, it's not quite a cooperative. It's what we call employee owned.
Right.
So it's not like a cooperative in that you don't have to have a meeting and votes on every decision. The management structure remains the same as it was, but the company actually belongs to all the employees who work there. So everybody who's worked for more than 6 months or so, if they stay for the end of the year, will receive shares.
Yep.
And what that means is that everybody has a vested interest in the success of the company. And last year we paid out a dividend for the first time, so that was quite exciting for people. Mm. 10 years ago, when we were talking about putting organic products on, and everybody said, "Well, nobody's interested, don't bother." But how quickly that's turned around. It's very encouraging. And interestingly, we noticed it because we deal with all sorts of customers. We do mail order, and we also do wholesale. So we do everybody from, you know, the lady down the street to British Airways. It was actually the general public who were the first to kind of come to us and say, you know, "Oh, we really like the fact that it's organic," or, you know, to ask the questions, and that the actual trade side has taken longer to catch up, which is quite interesting.
Yeah.
If this fairly fragile ecology was damaged, then, you know, apart from anything else, we'd be out of business very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Because if, you know, the water, the lot gets polluted, then the shellfish, etc., won't grow. So from a purely business point of view, it's absolute common sense to look after where we are. From an ethical point of view, we also, you know, strongly believe that we apply that principle not only to what we're doing here, but also to our suppliers, you know, because we produce oysters and mussels here, and we smoke salmon, but we also source a lot of goods from other suppliers, local suppliers. For instance, fresh salmon comes from Shetland and Hebrides, and we very much cultivated small independent salmon farms that we know exactly what they do. We can check their methods. They're either organic or fume food. And in fact, a lot, you know, we found that with the mussel lines, actually what's happening there is you're bringing in a lot of, there's more biodiversity in the sea life than there was before, because there's things like underneath the mussel lines, there's a whole bed of starfish who are feeding off the mussels that drop off the lines.
Yeah.
That wasn't there before. And they're also, you know, it's encouraging langoustine and that sort of thing into this top half of the loch, which tends to be, you know, not as full of sea life as further down the sea, because it's a lot further for species to come, and also the sort of fresh seawater balance is good for some sea life, but not so good for others. So it's actually having a positive impact. I think people do look to Loch Fyne as a brand that you can trust, that the food is going to be good and well sourced. And there's, you know, there's a lot of confusion in labelling, and there's so many different labels out there in terms of where food comes from, that I think people look to us as for the reassurance that we've kind of done our homework, and that, you know, what they buy from us is, as I say, well sourced, as well as being really good to eat.
Mm.
I mean, smoking salmon in Scotland is a very traditional process. It's, you know, it was done really to preserve fish, not to make it taste good, but just to make it last longer when people didn't have fridges and freezers, etc. And the process that we use is entirely traditional. It's based on the way it's been done for over centuries. At the start of the process, if you've got to get a really good quality salmon to start with, and that's why I was saying about working with these independent salmon farms, we don't smoke wild fish at all, because it's completely unsustainable as a commercial product. And
yeah.
In fact, there's nothing that makes us more angry is when you see chefs on the television saying, "You must get wild salmon." Well, I mean, you know, to us it's almost like saying, "You must find a dodo to eat." Here we hand fillet it, and we fillet it in a particular way from the head towards the tail, which is, again, slightly different to other smokehouses. And that gives a very clean fillet, which is then ready for smoking. The curing, again, we dry cure, which means you put the salt and the sugar on straight. You don't. The alternative is that is what's called brine curing, which is when you actually put it in a liquid.
Yeah.
The advantage of that, if you're trying to make lots of money, is that the fish doesn't lose any weight in that process. However, that's the curing and the taste isn't nearly as good. If you dry cure, there's actually a lot of moisture comes out of the fish, and you can lose about a third of its weight. So you dry cure it, you hand fillet it, you dry cure it. You then use the kilns, which are we'll call using open fireboxes. So the smoke is generated by fire, and it, again, but you can generate smoke by using electricity, which produces a different type of smoke. The fires are burning with wood chips from old whiskey barrels, which again, well, you'll see when you go around the smokehouse tomorrow, but you can actually smell the whiskey in the smokehouse. I wouldn't have said our salmon was whiskey flavoured, but there's definitely a kind of a richness and a quality in the wood. So it's American oak from whiskey barrels. The whiskey industry in Scotland, we're glad to say, is thriving. So there's plenty of whiskey casks to use. And again, that's a nice bit of recycling, because what happens when they finish with a whiskey cask, it gets made into garden tubs, and the bits in between get made into chips for smokehouses. So then over the open fire boxes, and it's smoked. Again, the actual smoking time isn't an exact science. That depends on the experience of the smokers to know when it's ready to come out of the kiln. So if it's a particular cure, like our classic, it's sort of 12 hours at a fairly, what we call ambient temperature, about 20 degrees. But again, it can depend on the moisture levels in the air outside, how long you're going to smoke it for. So that, again, depends on experience and people knowing, you know, when it's ready to come out of the kiln. And you then leave it to rest. Again, that's important. You know, the whole process is not speedy. Because if you try and slice it straight out of the kiln, it doesn't slice properly. And then you used experience slicing slices, you know, to produce the final product. It's a very hands-on process, and it's monitored at every level in terms of quality. And there isn't, you know, we believe you can't rush it. And we make everything to order, which gives us problems, you know, when suddenly we get customers coming in wanting a fast turnaround of order. Sometimes we can do it if we've got stock built up, but a lot of the time it's a juggling game to make sure you've got the right stocks coming in out at the end that the customers are wanting.
Mm.
So that's, you know, really what makes the salmon very special.